Hearts of Fire and the Nanny won't be seen tonight. Please stay tuned for this special presentation.
In December of 1995, stomach virus-stricken 6-year-old Billy Corr lied in bed in his home in Greensboro, North Carolina, watching the Flintstones on Cartoon Network, while his father was across town at the newly opened Best Buy, buying something that would change young Billy's life
forever.
That evening, he brought home a Packard Bell Legend 822 CDT desktop computer, the family's first computer. Billy was able to work up enough strength to occasionally enter the dining room and watch his dad hook the computer up. Billy was in there when it first booted into Windows 95. Over the next several years, this Packard Bell would change Billy's life by encouraging him to pursue a career in computers and technology. Billy spent most of his time on the Legend 822 CDT, playing computer games such as Earthworm Jim, Putt-Putt, Fatty Bear, Freddy Fish, The Incredible Machine, My First Encyclopedia, among many others. The computer was given away in the spring of 2000 and has never been seen since. In 2005, at the age of...
Years or so, that computer became the joy of my life. I played so many computer games on it, had so many good times on it. I learned how to use a computer with that computer. And my career path right now, which is computer information technology, never could have happened if it wasn't for that Packard Bell. And Pat, right now we got a few friends of mine on Skype. We got Chris Rogers, Jay Wakefield, Randy, and Matthew H16, or whatever his name is. And I have been searching for this computer for 8 years, and I haven't seen it in 13 years. It was given away in the summer of 2000, and I've never seen it since. Now, one thing we need to keep in mind, before I say that, today, something just arrived in the mail that I've been waiting for 8 years, an authentic Packard Bell Legend 822 CDT desktop computer. Exactly like my original childhood one. Now, this isn't the one I had as a child, but it's the same model and everything. And I have been after one of these for 8 years now. And I'm getting kind of emotional right now, but because I can't believe this day has finally come. And what happened was, about a month ago, it was, I think, the week before Easter, a friend of mine named Ian found a Packard Bell Legend 822 CDT for sale on the Vintage Computer Forum. And he jumped right on it. He, with help from some of my friends, we were able to pay for it, and he had it shipped to his house. He fixed a few little bugs with it, and then he sent it out to me Saturday, and it just arrived on my carport about 10 minutes ago. And I don't think we need to delay this anymore. Let us now proceed with the most important unboxing I have ever done. I can't stress this enough. This is a moment I've been waiting for since I was 15 years old. I can't believe this day is here. Now let's soak this in for a moment. This is my childhood computer I'm unboxing. This is where it all started, right here in this box. So let's proceed right now. All right. Use a lot of tape here. Boy, I'm getting goosebumps. I've got butterflies in my stomach right now. I'm gonna turn the sound down just a little bit on the computer. Okay. And this is also being broadcasted on Rockin' Waves as well. Okay, that might be good enough. We're getting closer, folks. The box has been opened. Oh my gosh, here it is. Here it is, folks. This is it. Computer I've been waiting 13 years to get. I'm about to lift it out right now, folks. Thank you. ever made.
You're still great to me.
Now you can see the CD drive looks a little funky. This is not original, but I have a better looking drive to put in here. There's the floppy drive. And look how pristine this computer looks. It looks like it's brand new. And here is the spec sticker. This is the spec sticker I remember seeing on mine. It has a 100 megahertz Pentium processor, a 1.2 gigabyte hard drive, which it is no longer in here, unfortunately, 16 megabytes of RAM, upgradable to 72 megabytes, quad speed CD-ROM, which is obviously not there anymore, designed for Windows 95. My goodness, folks. And there's the model number. This is proof that this is indeed the real thing. Let's turn it around. It uses a Packard, a PB600 motherboard, just like mine did. The sound card is not the original, I can tell, because this looks like a later era sound card for a Packard Bell, but I have a better one to put in anyway. And it was manufactured September 28th of 1995. According to a friend of mine, this particular Packard Bell 822 shipped with Windows 3.1 instead of 95. But my childhood one had Windows 95 on it, not 3.1. But even if this particular one did come with 3.1, I'm going to see to it the only operating system this computer sees is Windows 95. And if you suggest Windows 2000, you will be getting a noogie.
Murdered! Matthew, you had one job!
Also, it's interesting to note here. It's interesting to note here, even though this computer has obviously been tinkered with inside, the quality seal still looks like it hasn't been broken. So that's kind of interesting. Oh my gosh, it almost fell off the bed.
Oh my goodness.
But I gotta
live long enough to power up the Packard Bell.
At least be able to turn it on, then you know.
But folks, I need to change a few settings inside of it before I first fire it up. But we will be back momentarily. Hold on, folks. Hey, I got the Packard Bell all together, put a new CD-ROM drive in it, and I put a new hard drive in it. And I put a different sound card in it as well. The reason I'm making this video in the dining room is because I got this Packard Bell Legend 822 CDT in roughly the same spot the original one was. Now, obviously I won't be using it in here. And for one thing, we don't have a desk in here anymore. This is just an old stereo console my grandmother used to have from the 70s. This was good enough just to take a couple of pictures. So yeah, this... When I was back in the 90s, when I'd want to play a game on here or do something with this, I would just turn it on and I would sit right here. Now, these pictures weren't here, of course, because there was a desk hutch in the way, but for this, where my mom's doll is right here, it would be the mouse and the keyboard and the monitor on the desk. And those are some good times, folks. So I think it's about time to take this back in my bedroom and hook it up and see what happens for it on its maiden voyage. Hey, I got the Packard Bell all together, put a new CD-ROM drive in it, and I put a new hard drive in it. And I put a different sound card in it as well. The reason I'm making this video in the dining room is because I got this Packard Bell Legend 822 CDT in roughly the same spot the original one was. Now, obviously, I won't be using it in here. For one thing, we don't have a desk in here anymore. This is just an old stereo console my grandmother used to have from the 70s. This was good enough just to take a couple of pictures. So yeah, this, when I was back in the 90s, when I'd want to play a game on here or do something with this, I would just turn it on and I would sit right here. Now, these pictures weren't here, of course, because there was a desk hutch in the way, but for this, where my mom's doll is right here, it would be the mouse and the keyboard and the monitor on the desk. And those are some good times, folks. So I think it's about time to take this back in my bedroom and hook it up and see what happens for it on its maiden voyage. Now. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the moment we've been waiting for. We are about to power on the Packard Bell Legend 822 CDT. Here we go. And we got a power on self test, folks. How much RAM do we have? 32, very good amount for this.
Yeah, that seems to be impressive.
And looks like we have a small problem with the hard drive, folks. We will be right back. Okay, guys, I got it all back together. I think what the problem was I had a jumper in the hard drive where it shouldn't have been. So, and I also had a little accident with it. This Packard Bell fell off my desk, unfortunately, and crashed into this cheap HP power supply. So, and it took a little chunk out of it. I certainly hope this computer still works. If not, oh, this will be a disaster. But here we go, folks. And all is good.
Peace, guys. Peace.
Seeing the hard drive? And folks, we are in. We are in like swimwear, as Spy Fox would say. Now, there is something on this hard drive right now. It's the operating system from the last computer it was in. I had it in my Gateway 2486, but I will wipe all this off of it and put a good old-fashioned Packard Bell installation on here. So, hold tight, folks. We are going to start the restoration process. So far, so good, folks. We are now restoring the Packard Bell with the Master CD. It's what I think is the one that came with the computer originally, format number 556020. And it'll probably take about 15 or 20 minutes or so, but this is looking good, folks. Very good. Okay, guys, we are back now. It's done restoring. Now we are going to reboot the computer. Alright, restore complete. For changes to take effect, the system must be restarted. Remove all disks and CDs and reboot the system. Okay. Get out of here. Take the flippity floppity floopity disk out. And we will do a Control Alt Delete and restart. And the camera is having focus problems today for some reason. Of all days, too. Okay, we're good now. Alright. Oh yeah, my favorite screen. Congratulations on the purchase of your new Packard Bell computer. We are sure that it will meet your computing needs. You know, I've seen this message quite a bit, but today it seems extra special. In fact, I'm gonna take a picture of it right now to commemorate this. Get my phone out. Wow. Packard Bell and a Galaxy S3. Two completely different things, huh? Okay, let's see here. Hold on, I gotta stop for a second. Okay, took the picture. Now we'll go to the next screen. Thank you for choosing Packard Bell. Why, you're welcome. And I wish that were an old joke. Yeah, I put a Western Digital drive in here, a 2 GB. And it's really going at it, huh? Actually, we'll be right back. Okay, the restore is almost done, as you can see. Windows 95 is almost done installing. Alright, we got sound. Alright. This is great. Alright, Windows 95 is booting up. And I'll have to reconfigure the DOS CD-ROM driver, since this is not an original Packard Bell CD-ROM. And here we are! And I think I know what's about to pop up on here. Any second now.
Welcome from Packard Bell. We offer you two computing environments to choose from. Packard Bell's Navigator or Microsoft Windows. You may also begin by taking a quick lesson on using the mouse.
Oh, the lesson on using the mouse. You know, I retired those jokes, but this is an 822. I need to bring them back. Wow, the lesson on using the mouse. What an amazing time that was. You know what? You know what I think I'm gonna do? Let me pull out my, one of my Packard Bell Navigator CDs.
Welcome to Navigator's Living Room.
And let's take that lesson on using the mouse. How about that? I don't know if we'll be able to do a whole lot because my battery is about to die. I hope it hurries up and loads.
Hi, and welcome to a brief lesson on using your mouse. Now, before we begin, remember you can always use your keys on your keyboard to move around. To return to where you were originally, just press the escape key. And to move ahead, press the enter key. If you need help at any time, just press the question mark key. Now we'll introduce you to your mouse and answer some basic questions.
Hello,
mouse.
Why should
I use a mouse? How do I use it? And how do I use the mouse when I'm working with text? To begin with, your mouse is a tool to let your computer know what you want it to do. You use the mouse to point, click, and drag. Go ahead, try moving the mouse. Rest your palm on the round part of the mouse and move it around on the pad.
Oh, this is so relaxing.
You can see how the arrow on the screen mirrors the mouse movement. Now move the mouse so the pointer goes off the screen. To get the pointer back, just move the mouse a bit until it appears on your screen again. Now let's practice pointing. Try to move the mouse so the arrow moves over the blue gear. You click on an object by pressing and quickly releasing the left mouse button while the pointer is over that object.
You know what, guys? As much as I'm enjoying this, my battery's about to die, so I need to save my battery strength for other stuff about this computer. Let's head back into Windows. And the date's, the time's a little bit off. It's actually 4:05. She's real fine. My 4:05. No, that's 4:09, actually. There we go. And we will go into the system properties. And here we are. Packard Bell Pentium, 32 megs of RAM. Wow, there's actually no communications port conflict on here. That's rare for a Packard Bell. And we got the good old Packard Bell sound card. Oh, and while I still got power on my camera, we need to do the most important thing, especially on a computer like this. It's time for the Canyon test. Never sounded better, folks. And that's enough for now. I'll be back in a little bit with more on this computer once I get my battery charged. I'll be back later, folks. And we're back several hours later. It's about 8:30 p.m. Had this computer for about 7 hours now. I guess it's time to really show off what this Legend 822 CDT is capable of. So we'll fire it up. Okay, focus now, camera. You can do it. You can do it. Oh, there we go. And this computer has 32 megabytes of RAM, and coincidentally, sometime around 1997 or 1998, our original 822, we actually had Best Buy upgrade the RAM from 16 megs to 32, so this is up to speed on that, and it's, I guess, this 822 is going to pick up from where the last one stopped. And who knows, for all I know, this 822 might very well be my original. Who knows, it may have found its way to Atlanta, Georgia sometime after 2000. But yeah, here is the Packard Bell Legend 822 CDT all fired up. This wallpaper right here is actually the wallpaper that our original 822 used at one time. I don't know how long we used it, but I know we had this because in a video from June of 1996 of our original Packard Bell, it shows it, this wallpaper on there, so that's kind of interesting, and I was able to do a little bit of digging via Google, and I found this picture, and I got it back now. And I'll be right back. I'm going to switch to my tripod. Okay, we got the tripod all set up now. So let's take a look at what this computer has to offer. And I've installed a bunch of my games on it already, including the first computer game we ever got for it. You see, the day after my dad bought our original 822, he went to Sam's Club and purchased three computer games for me to start me off. He got 3D Ultra Pinball by Sierra. Very good game. The Berenstain Bears Get in a Fight, another good game, which is by Living Books, and another Living Books game, which happens to be my favorite of the series, Just Grandma and Me. And because the Living Books Buick Mafia has disbanded, thank goodness, we're going to take a quick look at this game. I figure it's only proper since it was the first game we got on our 822. Okay. What's interesting about these early Living Books games is that they're one of the few programs I've seen whose owner's manual says it's compatible with Windows 3.0 Multimedia Edition. I mean, multimedia extensions. I have never really seen many programs that are designed for a version of Windows that old. But it runs on that and Windows 3.1 and Windows 95, and I've gotten it to run on Windows 98 as well. And no, I will not be installing Windows 98 on this computer. Windows 98 is a nice operating system, but it just doesn't belong on a computer like this. So here we go with Just Grandma and Me.
Just Grandma and Me by Mercer Mayer.
Hi, I'm Little Critter. Welcome to Living Books. To have the story read to you, press this button. To play inside the story, press this button.
You know, I've said it before, and I'll say it again about these storybook games from the 90s. They always have these two options. You can play inside the story or just have it read it to you. Okay, let's say you were 6 years old, like I was at the time, and you had the choice between playing or just having it read to you. Really? We're gonna play inside the story.
We went to the beach, just Grandma and me.
Good for y'all. I love this music, by the way. Screams 90s computer game. And it has click points like a Humongous Entertainment game would. Whoa, that's kind of scared me. At least it's not that same moo sound Humongous Entertainment used in all their games. I think it went like, no.
Can I sit by the window?
You may, if there's room, dear.
Did you know that, there's a funny little backstory to this game. Grandma is actually voiced by a man. Yeah, that's a true story as well. I couldn't believe that, but it makes sense, I guess. Although, I feel sorry for a little critter that his grandfather is, into that kind of stuff. That, my friends, is my favorite part of the whole game. Even as a kid, I loved when Grandma, or Grandpa in this case, would make this sound. You get it. But yeah, it's... there's a certain page I want to go to, but I want to see if I can get to it without going through all the other pages. I don't know if that's possible. I guess we'll find out here.
If you want to play inside a certain page, click on the arrow to select the page you want, and then click
there.
Okay.
We go. Here it is.
Okay. I bought hot dogs for Grandma and me, but they fell in the sand, so I washed them off.
Ew. That is so unsanitary. Listen to how crunchy those hot dogs are. I guess the sand is making that noise, but... Okay, this needs a good analyzation here. Little critter went to this stand called Good Food, which I question its advertising abilities. He brought the hot dogs down to the seashore, dropped the hot dogs in the sand, which is where crabs poop in, and he picked up the hot dogs full of sand, dipped them into the ocean, which is full of salt and who knows what. You know they dump toxic chemicals into the ocean, and put them back in the bun, gave one to his grandma, gave one to himself, and now they're both eating hot dogs that have been thrown in the sand, thrown in the dirty ocean, and, you know, something tells me that these two folks right here will be paying a nice little visit to the emergency room that evening. But I digress. Let's move on to bigger and better things.
Do you have the story? Do you want to quit? Okay.
No, I just felt like pressing the quit button. Yeah, that was pretty much the first game I ever had on this computer. And, you know, even though this is probably not the original Legend 822 CDT from my childhood, but you know what? Let's just go ahead and say it is, because it's pretty much the same thing. Let me put this back in the case and go on to another game that I got the day after we got this computer. Sierra's 3D Ultra Pinball. Okay. Would you like to run Ultra Pinball? Why, sure. I'm glad you asked me that. I'm very honored. Love this part coming up.
Phew! Sierra!
Okay, let's play us some pinball. Let's play the colony level.
Colony table activated. To start bonus events, hit the glider twice. Good luck.
Yeah, this was a very good game. In fact, I remember my aunt had this on her Gateway 2000 as well. Actually, come to think of it, she also had Just Grandma and Me. Good old-fashioned FM synthesis at its finest. And this is my computer gaming skills at its not-so-finest. I don't even know if you can see very good on this. This game had subsequent sequels, other versions of this, but I never had any of those as a kid. All I had was this original one, which is probably the best one, most likely. Alright, and you can play the whole game with the mouse. After taking the lesson on using it, of course. You know, this really isn't all that 3D, to be honest. And I think, Lazy Game Reviewer... Whoa! That was weird. I think even Lazy Game Reviewer mentioned that this was not all that 3D. But hey, you know, it doesn't matter how good something is. If it gives you nostalgia, then it's perfectly okay to me. And I believe that was it. Let's see. Don't want to give out my actual name. So I will type in, let me think. Josh Groban's a legitimate name, isn't it? Yeah, enough of that.
And I guess we ought to play one more game. The other game I got the day after was Berenstain Bears getting a fight, but since we already showed a Living Books game a moment ago, there's really no need to show it, but I will do a video of it eventually. Okay, now I think it's time to play the very first humongous entertainment game I ever had on this computer. Putt-Putt joins the parade. And by the way, all the CDs you've seen tonight, all the CD-ROM games, these are the original copies I had as a kid. So, yeah. And I haven't tried Humongous on here yet. Oh yeah, remember this screen, folks? It's a pretty fast drive I have in here, so it probably shouldn't be too bad. Any day now. Raring to go now. Oh, I love it when it does this. Little promo for another classic game that I absolutely love.
Hi, I'm Putt-Putt. Come join me on my adventure. I'm ready to go.
Oh yeah, this is perfect, folks. Folks, I feel like I'm 6 years old again, and I mean it. I'm teary-eyed right now.
I think I'll turn on my radio.
Good morning!
I mean, I play this game all the time on my other Packard bills, but this particular time feels extra special.
Drive on down to the Cartown Fountain with your pet, and Smokey the Fire Engine will sign you up so you can march in the parade. Don't be a crankcase. Get in gear and join the fun.
That sounds great. I wish I had a pet.
I wish I had a lot of things, Putt-Putt. You don't see me wanting.
I'd better get ready.
Oh, yeah.
Flying breakfast.
Yeah, it's pretty sad I can quote this game so well.
Oh, boy,
you know, a lot of times people ask me why I don't ever play any of the newer Humongous Entertainment games, you know, like Pajama Sam or Spy Fox. Well, as much as I like those games, those are very, very classic games, love them to death, but, well, the original Humongous games I had back in the day were this one, Putt-Putt Goes to the Moon, and Fatty Bear's Birthday Surprise, the first Freddy Fish game, and Putt-Putt Saves the Zoo. So, those games just have a little bit of extra nostalgia to them, and that's why I prefer them. Yeah, I always like a little bit of oil in my cereal. And believe it or not, folks, my entire life I have always preferred dry cereal. It's not that I don't like milk, it's just it makes the cereal too soggy and it takes away from the flavor of this actual cereal.
It's time to brush.
Wow. Today I got reunited with my childhood computer and all I can talk about is how I like dry cereal. Whoa.
This coin will come in handy. It's a swell day for a parade.
It certainly is. I How about them apples? Oh, boy, that's not good. That is not good at all, folks. I love this part. You can just click it so much repeatedly, and all these fish will pop out of the pond. And then, if we're lucky, yep, there's that shark.
How I could get past that cow.
Well, you know, you could just drive out into the grass and go around it. Or you could go the cruel route.
Now I can keep on driving.
Well, hello.
You know what? I don't feel like playing all this game. I only have so much time for this video. And I keep knocking laptops down. That is, lovely. Okay, should we play anything else? Do we have time? I'd show off some DOS games on here, but I haven't had a chance to put any on here yet, so, no Sky Roads Road 3 tonight. Which is probably a good thing. Let's see. What else can we take a look at? Oh, I know. I don't want to show too much of this, cause it's kind of a long one, but right here is, now this isn't my original copy of the game. I lost it years and years and years ago, and I, obtained another copy of it thanks to eBay about 2 or 3 months ago. It's a little game called The Adventures of Digby the Dog. Bought it at Best Buy back in 1996. So we will head on over there. The Key Kids group. Whoa, that is.
Hi, I'm Shelley Duvall.
That is.
Digby is a little Yorkshire Terrier, a Yorkie. He's so small.
That okay. Something is horribly, horribly wrong here. Normal dogs normally don't talk. No, seriously though, it looks like the color scheme is all screwed up or something. There we go. I don't think that's right.
Okay. For my world. This is my garden and my house. Nice, isn't it?
Shelley Duvall.
I live here with Shelley and Dan and lots of birds.
Just.
Digby.
I know she's some kind of celebrity, but I don't know what she does. What she's famous for, other than creating this computer game, but I've heard that name so much. And Digby's a Yorkie, and I actually own a Yorkie. That's kind of interesting.
Isn't this garden pretty? Jasmine smells wonderful.
I will save the rest of this game for later.
Okay.
But yeah, that's. That, my friends, was the Packard Bell Legend 822 CDT. Again, folks, I had been searching for this computer since 2005. I had about lost hope. I never thought I'd see this computer again. But guess what? It happened. And folks, I normally don't get serious in my videos, but all of you should know that if you want something like this, never give up. It took me 8 years, yes, but I did find one. And we all have the ability to do whatever we want. You know, I am going to quote my all-time favorite hero, Mr. Rogers, by saying, "All of you're special in your own way." I don't think that's exactly how he worded it, but you know, you can do whatever you want if you put your mind to it. And I also want to thank all of my subscribers and all the viewers I've had over the past several years of my YouTube career. I mean, if it wasn't for your support and your dedication, I wouldn't be making these videos. And I also want to let you know that I am not done collecting Packard Bells. Just because I got my childhood computer back, I'm not done collecting Packard Bells. I'd still like to get a corner desktop someday if I can ever find one. Those are quite even more rare than this. And there's also an all-in-one computer, which is really, really cool looking. But it's even more rare than the corner desktop and an 822 combined. And I think I should also go ahead and make a little announcement. Do you guys remember a little computer known as the Packard Bell Legend 1510 Supreme? Well, ladies and gentlemen, it has been repaired. My friend Jeremy, aka ULTBW100 here on YouTube, was so kind enough to offer me to ship him the motherboard for it. Keep in mind, the problem it had was the CPU socket got destroyed. And what he did was he soldered a new CPU socket on it, and it's as good as new. Once he mails me back the motherboard, you will be seeing a video of me rebuilding the Packard Bell Legend 1510 Supreme. You know, as much as I like my 822, both editions of it, the 95 version and the 13 version, there's something quite special about that 1510 Supreme. It was the first modern-day Packard Bell I ever bought back in 2005, and I had a lot of good times with it, so it'll be great to have it back in service again. And let me be honest, I am dying to take the most awesome Packard Bell picture of the Legend 822 CDT and the Legend 1510 Supreme together. Now, that might break my camera through the awesomeness, but it's worth the risk. And so with that said, again, thank you everyone, and a big thank you to my friend Ian for making all of this possible. Without you, this wouldn't be in my house today. And so for now, this is Billy Corr, signing off on April 29th, 2013. Good night, everybody.